Welcome you all. My name is Prem Shankar. I'm here to present my project, one on data analysis and the other one on NLP, that is natural language processing. The title of the data analysis project is Data Analysis Using Python, that is Exploratory Data Analysis of Antibiotic Drugs Review. So I have taken the drugs, the antibiotic drugs which is taken by the patients. So based on the patients or the customer's review, I have analyzed the data and have identified using the sentiment analysis, which is a part of NLP. And I have segregated the data based on positive review, negative review, and neutral reviews. As the main objective of the sentiment analysis, is to identify the opinion within the text, like what a person is talking about. So I have just made a small image which I have imported into the Jupyter notebook. And before starting this project, I just want to tell you, like, I have used the Python platform with the Jupyter notebook, and like this is an image for the sentiment analysis with the historical reviews based on the historical data. So it's not like current data, but based on the historical reviews of the patients, the sentiment annotation. Sentiment annotation. Annotation means it can be either in two forms, one with the image or with the text form. But I have taken in the text form. Within the text, like based on the data, we are like I have identified what the customer has said, whether it's a positive, negative, or neutral. So this comes under text classification. So with that text classification, I have done the text cleaning processes. Text cleaning. Then comes the word embedding. So in text cleaning, what I've done is like I've removed the unwanted data, the data which is not required for building the model or in order to develop the model. Unwanted data, so I have done the then that is comes under text cleaning. Then the word embedding. So word embedding plays a very important role, to identify how much it comes under the Keras platform, and it helps to identify like converting the text data into vector representation, because the words is it will be in a variables and it needs to be converted into numbers form. So I have the text data are converted into vector representation. The algorithm will be able to, these word embedding algorithm, they will be able to generalize these words to do any kind of predictions. So word embeddings give us the way to use the efficient dense representation in which the similar words have or similar encoding. Then the model training and model evaluation. So this is the flowchart of my project. This is a production flow, but I haven't done with these new reviews, but in future I'm planning to do the with the new reviews and sentimental scores. I haven't used the user interface platform currently, but in future I'm planning to build the user interface platform for this project. Currently I have done only the coding part in the Jupyter platform. So before going into the project, I just want to showcase the data which I have collected. I'll be sharing the screen now. This is my data screen, like the data which I have collected. These data I have downloaded mainly from the website of University of California, from the University of California, like a it's like a data repository, like a drug review data, which provides the reviews of specific drugs. Specific, for example, these drugs are used for both for cancer patients and for even for chronic patients with heart patients. Most of the drugs are being used, different varieties, different generic names and different chemical names has been used in this one. You can see the drug names, and these are the codes for each drugs but we are not concentrating on the codes, but we are just concentrating on the ratings of each drugs. Because the ratings is the most important for this project. Sentiment analysis is mainly based on the rating and its count. So effectiveness. So what are the things I'm going to concentrate is mainly the main thing is the benefits. The based on the benefits review, based on the side effects review and the comments review, these sentiment analysis been performed and also based on the rating. So column C and column E and benefits review, column F. So while doing the project, while doing in the platform, you can see the clear picture of it. But it's just an Excel sheet because we got a huge data. It's more than 1,000. The data is more than 1,000 plus around 1,073, I think so. 1,073. The exact count is more than 1,073. So it's a very huge database. So I'll be going into the notebook now, Jupyter notebook. So before going into this Jupyter notebook, I thought of showing you from where, from which screen I have collected the datas. Just give me a minute. This is the website which I have collected this data, machine learning repository data. These are the ones from here because of classification. You can see lots of data is available. From here, I have collected the drugs data. From the drugs data, I have segregated based on the sentiment analysis, which is my project. So I'm going into the Jupyter notebook now. So in this one, like I have imported the image using PIL import image. I have used the path from where the JPG file. From there, I have imported this image. This is a model of my project. So importing Python libraries. So what are the libraries? Import pandas, that is a basic one. Import pandas as PD, I've imported a like imp I have imported a sklearn, which is which tells about the data mining library for Python. It provides a powerful array of tools to classify, cluster, classification. As I have used the classification method, I have used sklearn and import Keras. So here, Keras is mainly used for word embedding. As I have used in word embedding, I have used the library. I have imported the libraries of Keras. Then NumPy tells about the numerical numbers, like as dealing with the numerical datas. I have imported the library of NumPy. Then XLRD. The XLRD library is a module that allows the Python to read the data from the Excel files. Then the collections library. The collection is like a container that can be used to store the collections of data, for example, list, dictionary set, tuples, etc. I have imported the matplotlib. This is one of the major things, to showcase the data in a visualized form, either in bar graph or in line chart, in different representation, but I have used bar graph in my project. Then comes the NLTK. NLTK, as we are aware about, that is like a natural language toolkit, which is a suite for libraries and programs for statistical language processing. Then I have imported the Word Cloud, which says about the quick visualization technique used for representing the text data. Then I have used the sklearn library, which helps to score the utility functions or the classification of the performance. So reading the data. So the first thing is, so the now we need to import the data from the Excel sheet. So I'm going to read the data from the Excel sheet. I need to import. I'm using the train pd.read underscore csv. This is a pathway from where we have seen the Excel sheet. From here, I am importing the data, reading the data into. I'm just running it once so that. So the data has been imported. Then the overview of the data. So we are, as we saw the Excel sheet contains too many data, but in order to have a crispy manner, like to showcase what are the headings, what are the columns which comes. So I just want to showcase, as it is a very big data. So in order to reduce it and to make it a unique to showcase what is a comes, like I have used the code train.head. So this gives the random five. Just give me a minute. Any of the five one random five numbers with unnamed. What are the rows which comes? What are the columns which comes? So unnamed drug names, ratings, effectiveness, side effects, conditions, benefits review, side effects review, comments review. So this helps to identify what the data tells about and what is the data is inside. So what needs to be done in the project. So replace the NaN. So replace NaN means like we got a huge database. There are some data which is missing. For example, some data are missing with no comments with by the customer or by the patients. So the benefits review is not given, or the comments review is not given. So in that case, I need to remove the things like which is in empty. So what I did is I just used the train.fillNA with filling with dots. The empty data sets will be filled with dots. So once I run it, you can see here the empty data is being filled with dots. So here also you can see some benefits review is not given. Wherever the data is missing, then wherever the data is missing, it is given with dots. So it's been filled with dots. Instead, if I'm not using fillNA, I'm just gathering the data and running it, what will happen? It will be showing only NaN values, only NaN, no values. Instead of dots, it will be showing NaN. So I'm going to build the model now. So before building the model, what I need to do is I need to remove the dots. So I have filled with with the empty and the empty datas with the dots. Then I need to remove it. Now I'm planning to remove the remove columns with the null value. So train.fillNA, the dots will be removed. These things, the one which has been given as dots will be removed automatically. So convert the ratings. So what I used here is the confusion matrix. So as per the confusion matrix, it comes under machine learning process. So I'm training the model based on the confusion matrix. So here you can see the benefits and side effects equal to benefits review. I'm concentrating more only on the review part. I'm concentrating only on the review part. So here you can see benefits review, side effects review, comments review. So side effects. So here you can see benefits and side effects gives benefits review and side effects review. Benefits review and side effects review. This is my first training. The second one is I'm training with the benefits review and comments review. Benefits review and comments review. The first one is benefits review and side effects review. The second one is benefits review and comments review. The third one is the side effects review and comments review. Now I'm going to take with the side effects review and comments review. Then the third one is the side effects review and comments review. And the fourth one is all the comments like benefits review, side effects review, and comments review. I'm taking everything, benefits review, side effects review, and comments review. So I'm training the model based on it. And I'm running the data. And then comes the cleaning the data. So what are the things, the unwanted things which I don't want before building the model or before building the model of sentiment analysis? I don't want the unwanted data, so I want to remove the data. So what I'm doing is I'm using the drop function, unnamed drug name. So you can see here the unnamed drug name, then the effectiveness, side effects, and conditions. Unnamed drug name, effectiveness, side effects, and conditions. So these columns will be removed, and I'll be concentrating only on the review rating, benefits review, side effects review, and comments review. So I want to showcase only with the head. So I'm using the code train.head. So you can see the five rows showing the the main thing which has been removed. Like after removing, I'm just showcasing the benefits review, side effects review, and comments review. Then comments and side effects, comment benefits and comments, side effects and comments, and all comments. So based on this model, the model which is benefits and review, benefits and side effects, benefits and side effects, benefits and comments. The third one is side effects and comments and all comments and all comments. So the model has been trained accordingly. So as I told you, I have used the confusion matrix. The main thing is to do the sentiment analysis. So what is the reason for training the model is to do the sentiment analysis based on the positive review, negative review, positive rating, negative rating, and neutral rating. So we got the rating here, the rating of the patients or the customers. So I need to make the ratings with a count, how much rating, so like giving the rating level, like labeling the rating level as X label as rating level and Y label as rating review and the title. So once I run it, you can see the rating count. Rating count is just a title which I have given, the number of reviews, what is the number of reviews for a maximum 10. 10 comes as a positive one. And like I have given the counting frequency also, like how to check the frequency. Just give me a minute. Here we are going to do with the sentiment analysis. So combining the rating for the sentiment analysis, like positive, negative, and neutral, like less than 4 with the negative one and less than 8 rating as the neutral one, and like 10 as the positive one. So building the test model based on this one, and just running it. So I have used the pie chart from the collection, from the collection label. So I'm as like positive denotes the with the counter sizes, with the green, red, and blue. I have differentiated with the colors also. Positive as green and negative as red and neutral as blue. So the data, the total analysis is being trained to identify the positive reviews, neutral reviews, and negative reviews. So this is the part of the data analysis project. Next comes the natural language processing with the Python. Review on antibiotic drugs using sentimental analysis. So here the based on this data is a continuation, but I have used the NLTK. I have used the NLTK and I have used the counterweight, like for using the sklearn. I have used the sklearn libraries and NLTK for tokenization. As you are like, as most of the people are aware about the tokenization, as tokenization is essentially a splitting a phrase or a sentence or a pair or the entire text a document into smaller units, such as individual words, such as individual words. So building a frequency distance matrix, like as the sentence needs to have some distance matrices, I have given the distances and also the word distance as 30. We can give as 30, 40, 50, like that. And we are going to plot it. So PLT shows we are using the matplotlib. As I have imported the library of matplotlib as PLT. So I have used the top 100 words which I have the high frequency, top 100 words which have high frequency, because for example, if you are writing like if you're writing an essay or if you're writing any things, we'll be using the most just a minute. So if you are using in any paragraph or in any essays, we'll be using the words like I, S, was, like Grammarly, we'll be using these words or some of the words which keeps repeating. So the frequency of the words which doesn't needs to be in for the sentiment analysis, because we are concentrating mainly on the reviews of the patients. So for identifying the frequency of the words, what I have used is the word cloud. So when we get the data, the size of the each word indicates the frequency or the importance. The word cloud main concept is to identify the size of the words and its importance. So when we get the data, we wanted to know very quickly what are the prominent entities of the words it is talking about. And the good way to go get the idea text is plotting the word cloud. So which is a quick visualization technique, like used for representing the text data. So here I'll show you the code basically generates a word cloud for the review column. And let me first execute if the code, just give me a minute. Just give me a minute. Need to execute it from the first. So here it's a very simple code also. It's very the code is very straightforward. You can see the code here, word cloud max font size. So it is not complete while executing. The size of the words, the size here indicates the frequency. The main thing is the frequency or the importance. So these many words are frequently occurring in the review. So this is good to understand the dominant words are coming. what are the dominant words are coming. So this is a simple function creating with the rating. So for the rating, what are the important word that is coming? In this way, we are subsetting the data based on the review by the interpolation, like a PLT. We have used PLT. Like once we subset the word cloud is a method like which helps to for importing the word cloud package as I told you with the PLT in order to print the table. It's mainly to print the table PLT.show. It's a table, so you can see I then alphabet I, like it repeats how many times, what are the words and what are the frequencies, what are the words. So here you can see the words D has a frequency of 13180, 2 has a frequency of 104181, because has a frequency of 624. And apart from that, we can see what are the major power words which has been used in the data sets, like what are the power words, side effects, day night drugs. So these are the major words which has been highlighted. So build corpus. So we will be going with the corpus now. So corpus is a collection of text on which we wanted to do all the processing and generating of any model. So we can create our own text, whatever data we are handling based on it. So the text here, like here, we can, as I told you before, it's of the tokenization. As a tokenization is essentially splitting a phrase, sentence, or para. So based on that, we have made the combination and we have used the stop words. So these are some of the stop words. As the frequency is here, you can see the frequency here. So we don't want these words to be repeated or these words to be in the data. So I'm using the one which is called a stop words. So you can see all the words which has been having the frequency which has been highlighted here has been showcased for these stop words. To remove these words is mainly to remove these words from the data. So this is my NLP project, which helps, which needs to be gone through with the user interface, so that it makes a like my future studies, like in order to build the full model with the user interface, like making the customer to interact based on this sentiment and analysis. So that is my future project, which I need to go through it. And currently I have done with the sentiment annotation, text cleaning, word embedding, and model training. And model evaluation method and production flow will be done in the forthcoming projects. Most probably in my next semester, I'll be doing this project. Thank you.